and said, you know, look, mate, these are amazing things. He loved the Royal Air Force. And so that just, one of those things that you, goes in your brain when you were a kid and it percolates. You know. So in chimes our genius guitarist and goes, "Oi, bongos, shut the fuck up. Driving us all mental with your bashing and clanging." He goes, "Give him a hand with the chorus." Because what you just do, you know, if you've got a kind, any kind of a brain, you know, you spend, we were supporting people, so we would spend half an hour or 40 minutes on stage, and for the rest of the time go on. What do we do now then? So I started building guided missiles for fun. and so they did their best, but it wasn't terribly organised at first. It's brilliant now, but... So I know this is the first song because these two big monitors at the front are actually on the stage. Because they survived about 5 minutes, at which point I picked them up and chucked them in the audience. Which the audience loved, you know, yeah, abuse, equipment abuse, but the sound didn't get any better. So then a couple of songs later, we had this song called Revelations, right? And because I wrote it, I was like, oh, I want to play 15 seconds of guitar at the beginning of it, you know? So I had a guitar, and I put it on, and I'd play for a bit, and I'd take it off. And so what was the point, really? Well, actually, in fact, there was no point, because the fucking thing in 25 years was never, ever plugged in. A bunch of cunts, you know? I'm with my guitar, I'm Maury, and have a laugh. So I recommend go out, get yourself a couple of beers, come back, have a little action, gentlemen. It's a lump of concrete somewhere on the northeast coast, you know, with a beer tap connected to it, that occasionally used to do gigs. And I saw, we were doing a gig there with Samson and White Spirit, which was the Yannick's band engine. We're doing it, and that's where we first met, really. And we sort of ended up doing lots of stuff with each other. I mean, they're both good aeroplanes. They both do what they should do on the tin, you know, get people from A to B. But the difference is this: Airbus has a side stick and Boeing has a yoke. So an Airbus pilot is basically doing this. Whereas a Boeing pilot is just doing this. He goes, "No, don't worry, it's all right, I've done it before." He said, "You distract him and I'll drag him out." He said, "Can I drive?" I went, "Yeah." He said, "I can't, so yeah." He said, "Well, you take it and drive him across the fields at night, it's great." I said, "Go on." "Oh, God, I've found a hotel. Yeah. our pride. Thank you very much.